Hey there, Rails programmers. I'm Harriet Oughton. This is Rails in Focus, a series for the community. Oh no, already went wrong so early. Hey there, Rails programmers. I'm Harriet Oughton. This is Rails in Focus, a series by the community for the community, where we share Rails tips that have helped us in our own applications. Do you sometimes find yourself copying and pasting the same code again and again in different places throughout your app? Not very dry. Today, we'll look at a simple way to reuse code in multiple places and keep your codebase clean and tidy. Stay with us as we explore concerns in Rails. One of the core principles of Rails is clean, concise application development. So copying and pasting lots of code from one place to another is definitely a no-no. For one thing, this is messy, unnecessarily verbose, and makes it harder to maintain when we're having to remember all the places this functionality appears in order to make the correct changes in every place. Think, for example, of some complicated search functionality you've written and may want to use on more than one page, and therefore in multiple different controllers. Instead of all the copying and pasting, it's much better to extract our search logic into a neat concern that could itself be simply referenced in multiple different places. That way, we only add one new line to each controller, for example, including the concern and its logic, keeping our controllers clean and concise with the new functionality. Also, if any changes to the search functionality are needed, we can update it in only one place, in the concern itself. We'll look in a bit more depth at how to do this later on in the video. Now, you might be thinking, isn't a concern just a module? Essentially, you'd be right. It's sometimes hard to understand the difference between modules, mix-ins, and concerns, since they can all be used to store reusable functionality. But in the purest sense, concerns in Rails are modules that extend Rails' active support concern, which means that they contain some additional improvements to standard Ruby modules, such as allowing us to use cleaner and more readable syntax within them. Some developers also advocate the use of concerns to support yet another core principle of Rails application development, something called the single responsibility principle. Simply put, this principle in Rails means each piece of your code should do just one thing and do it well. For example, a model handles data, a controller manages traffic, and a view shows the pretty stuff. When we keep responsibilities separate and targeted in a Rails application by moving any specialized or shared behavior into concerns, our code can become easier to maintain, test, and understand. Essentially, there are different ways of defining concerns and different ways you can use them correctly. It's important to note that there are multiple opinions on this, not just the ones you see here. If you're getting started with concerns, it's quite okay to have a go at using them in your application first and get comfortable with the basic principles before researching further into the nuanced details. So let's dive in right now and look at some of the ways I've used concerns in the past. If we take a look at my product model, we can see how I've written this advanced search class method that I'm really pleased with. From my search field in my application, I can trigger this method to be called on product, and it will return all the product instances in my database that meet the given status and created app options, if they're provided by the user for the search. In fact, I'm so pleased with it that I now also want to use it on my account model so that I can offer my users the ability to search accounts. But wait, this is not very dry, and it will be hard to maintain as my app gets bigger, as I'll have to make any changes to my advanced search in two or more different models. This is such a good place to use a concern instead. We can see here that I've set up my concern as a new module, calling it searchable. The naming convention is that we end most model concerns with able to make it clearer to other developers that this file is a concern. On the second line, I've put extend active support concern. When we include this line, we make all of Rails' inbuilt concern support available to us so that all the magic can be handled by Rails behind the scenes. Pretty cool. Now I can paste into my concern any class methods like advanced search, scopes like search, or instance methods like search data that I want to be available on my models. Let's paste the advanced search method from my product model in now. I can remove the self at the start of this class method, as I don't need this inside the class methods block. When this is done, I make sure to include my new searchable concern in my product and account class, like so. I can also remove any duplicate code in my model, because any code defined within the concern is now available on my product and account model. This means I can call any of my concern methods or scopes on product or an instance of product like this. This is just one example, but there are loads of places we can use concerns if we think it's necessary. And it doesn't just have to be in models. We can use them in controllers as well, or almost anywhere. Some common examples are for authentication, for categorizable functionality, like adding a tag to a model, timestamping or audit logging, import-export capabilities, and many more. It's possible to fall into the pitfalls of overusing concerns to such an extent that your code becomes too abstract, so always remember to think about your code from the point of view of a new developer to the team. Is this class relatively easy for them to understand? If you sense that it might be too much of a headache for them to contribute to with only a little bit of a click around first, then the chances are that you've probably overcomplicated it. Try to keep your concerns as straightforward as possible, with only a few responsibilities each, and make sure your naming is as clear as possible. You could always add some helpful comment lines into the files too, to help your teammates and future contributors understand where the logic is stored. If you're using concerns across multiple models, don't forget that new models will often have different schemas, and this may muddy your design pattern or even cause breakages. Keep an eye out for circular dependencies between concerns too, where concerns reference other concerns, which may reference the first concern again. It's really easy to get into a bit of a muddle if you're not careful. In conclusion, concerns provide a clean way to organize and share code and are best used for clear, focused behaviors that appear in multiple places. Try to keep them single purpose and well documented, and consider them as just one tool in your Rails organization toolkit, but not the only solution. What ways have you found concerns to be really helpful in your applications? Drop us a comment below. We would absolutely love to hear your ideas and solutions. Thank you so much for joining us today at Rails in Focus for a look at concerns. Really hope to see you next time. Just trying to make sure there's nothing like no confidential like company documents just like kicking around anywhere or something.
Notifications? Yeah, I know. Oh, yeah.
It's like, Harriet, your pull request was rubbish. Like right in the middle.